Bonjour, c'est Virginie and you are watching French Truly TV, your destination to truly become a little bit French. Did you see my recent video, 8 French slang words starting with the letter C? That's because my plan is to repeat the experience with every single letter of the alphabet, and don't ask me why I started with the letter C, I have no idea. And today we'll do B. Follow through with this entire theme coming to you and you'll end up knowing a lot of argot, slang, argot. Little by little, 8 words at a time, very achievable. An excellent way to make you sound like a French language expert. Vous êtes prêts? Numéro 1, une bagnole. Une bagnole is a slang and mostly pejorative version of une voiture. Une bagnole or une voiture mean a car. Bagnole is not an elegant term, so be careful who you use this word with. Although, not being French, people might find it funny. I would. In the website Word Reference, I found the English translation to be crate or dustbin. What is that car parked in front of my garage? C'est quoi cette bagnole garée devant mon garage? C'est quoi cette bagnole garée devant mon garage? De balèze. With the adjective balèze, you can go 2 different ways. Big and strong, balèze. Or difficult. You're reading a difficult book and let's face it, you don't really understand it. Balèze. The actors who play in action movies are hefty. Les acteurs qui jouent dans les films d'action sont balèzes. Les acteurs qui jouent dans les films d'action sont balèzes. Ouf. Ah, this book is too hard for me. Ce livre est trop balèze pour moi. Ce livre est trop balèze pour moi. This word, balèze, is fine to use in general. It's not vulgar. Numéro 3, bordel. Bordel literally means brothel. However, these days, brothels are no longer legal, so bordel is more commonly used to describe a large mess. Don't go to my office, it's a total mess. Ne va pas dans mon bureau, c'est un bordel total. Ne va pas dans mon bureau, c'est un bordel total. Numéro 4, bosser. The verb bosser means travailler, to work. Usually the connotation is that you're working hard. It's not easy work, it's intense. It doesn't mean you don't enjoy it, but it's meant to express the idea of a certain hardship. I did some good work today, in the sense I achieved a lot today. I'm exhausted, but happy. J'ai bien bossé aujourd'hui. Je suis crevée, mais contente. J'ai bien bossé aujourd'hui. Je suis crevée, mais contente. Again, bosser is slang, but it's not vulgar at all. Numéro 5, un bide. Un bide is a noun that can mean 2 different things, a belly or a flop. Bide is familiar when it means belly, but acceptable in an average conversation. And it's not even that familiar for the flop. Just like when you say flop in English. It's not distinguished, but it's perfectly fine to use in all situations. With age and beer, he's getting a pot belly, but he doesn't care. Avec l'âge et la bière, il prend du bide, mais il s'en fiche. Avec l'âge et la bière, il prend du bide, mais il s'en fiche. This movie is rubbish and deserves to fail. Ce film est nul et mérite de faire un bide. Ce film est nul et mérite de faire un bide. Numéro 6, branché. Branché is an adjective that means à la mode and no, it has nothing to do with vanilla ice cream. À la mode or branché mean trendy. Mode means fashion, so it makes sense. Branché is used for places a lot, but not only. A theater could be branché, or a bar, or a restaurant, but a radio or a TV program could be branché too. This magazine provides a list of the trendiest bars in Lyon. Ce magazine donne la liste des bars les plus branchés de Lyon. Ce magazine donne la liste des bars les plus branchés de Lyon. Numéro 7, bobo. Un bobo is a small injury, a little scratch, a boo-boo. Yes, it usually belongs to the baby talk lexical field. What is that? A little boo-boo on your little knee?
Bah, qu'est-ce que c'est? Un petit bobo sur ton petit genou?
Qu'est-ce que c'est? Un petit bobo sur ton petit genou? Adults can use it too to insist on the fact that it's not much. Don't worry, it's a nothing type little scratch. T'inquiète, c'est juste un petit bobo de rien du tout. T'inquiète, c'est juste un petit bobo de rien du tout. By the way, we often say t'inquiète for ne t'inquiète pas. Don't worry, t'inquiète. It's a very common way of saying, don't worry, t'inquiète. Our last one, number 8, bouffer. I hate the verb bouffer, but people use it all the time, so I have to share it. It means to eat, but you need to picture someone who eats too much, too quickly, and maybe even noisily, like an ogre. It's not attractive. Now, somehow, when you use the noun la bouffe or une bouffe, which means food, it's not quite as bad. Though it's not the most elegant term you could use either. But it's not as bad as bouffer, the verb. And because we keep getting better, here's a whole saying. On s'appelle, on se fait une bouffe. On s'appelle, on se fait une bouffe. That is even better than the previous one because it's humorous. It means, let's have food together next time we hang out. On s'appelle, on se fait une bouffe. Literally, we call each other and we eat. But back to bouffer, the verb, since it's the one we started with. How does he stay so slim when he stuffs his face all day long? Comment il fait pour rester si mince alors qu'il bouffe toute la journée? Comment il fait pour rester si mince alors qu'il bouffe toute la journée? Now tell me, did you already know some of these French slang words? Bagnole, balèze, bordel, bide, branché, bobo, bouffé. Do you know more, starting with B? Share your comments with us on my website, frenchtrolley.com, under the blog tag. And of course, don't forget to subscribe. This was your French friend Virginie helping you become a little bit French. Merci beaucoup. Au revoir.